Under-21 Sevens football was back in fashion in Coalisland as a host of stars battled for the inaugural Gaelic Life Trophy. Fermanagh's Rory Foy, seen here scoring the goal, was just one high profile player on display. The play competition was won by Scotstown, who beat Downs Longstone. But it was the cup competition that really caught the imagination. The semi-final between Coalisland and Cardiff, seen here, was the game of the tournament. The hosts, Coalisland, were in scintillating form during the group stages, but when they met Antrim side Carrigan, they did not get everything their own way. Antrim County footballer Justin Crozier was Carrigan's linchpin, though in this instance his pass went astray, Stephen McNally made an interception, and Stephen Curran had a finishing touch. Stephen McNally added another goal as Coalisland ran out 4-7 to 4-6 victors. They booked their place in the final against Armagh's Craig Cuplin, who accounted for Antrim's Craigan in the other semi. In the final, McNally picked up where he left off. He scored this massive point and things looked dismal for the Armagh hopefuls. But some fine scoring of their own towards the end of the first half kept them within 5 points of Coalisland. Darren Monaghan's wonder goal towards the end of the game capped off a spirited Carrick Cup display. However, the Armagh men tired visibly and were unable to break down a solid Coalisland defence. At the whistle, Coalisland celebrated their 4-5 to 2-6 victory. The player of the tournament prize was chosen by Peter Hearn, the Macquarie Cup winning manager, and he selected Stephen Harrold, the Armagh County Under-21 from Carrick Cruppen. Harrold's size and pace proved vital to Cruppen's passage to the final. Harrold was also called upon to accept the runners-up prize of £500 worth of sports vouchers, which was presented by Gaelic Life editor Morris Kennedy. But it was Coalisland captain Shane Hughes that got his hands on the award everybody wanted, the Tyrone Crystal Gaelic Life Trophy. Hughes then went on to pay tribute to a gallant Carrick Cruppen side.
I'd like to offer our commiserations to Carrick Cruppen. It was a great final and it was very unlucky for them now. I'd like to thank them too.
The final word was left to Gaelic Life editor Morris Kennedy.
Well, it's been a very, very good competition, very high standard of football, and it's been played in a very competitive and a very good spirited manner, so we're very pleased to have been involved.